And welcome everyone to day number 4 of our spring summer season here at Grants Pass Downs, Tuesday, May the 18th. Little trivia for you, 41 years ago today, Mount St. Helens erupted. A lot of you Northwesterners might remember that day, so 41 years, crazy. Let's talk about today's 8-race card, which we have on this Tuesday program. Again, first post at Grants Pass Downs this season, 5:15 p.m. Pacific time. So 8:15 for you folks out there on the East Coast, a little late night action, usually closing up, I want to say just before 9 o'clock our time, usually about 8:45-ish. So we'll get you in bed before midnight if you're an East Coaster. But last Tuesday, of course, 570,000 worth of handle. So hopefully some good races to bet tonight. And hopefully you horse players out there enjoy the product. We start in the first race where we offer a $1 pick 4. We have a $1 pick 4 in the early 4 and the late 4. So races 1 and 5 start those pick 4s. And we start out with the number 1. Dizzy Dancer. This is a field of 6 going 6.5 furlongs. It's a 25 non-winner of the year. It's actually a non-winner in 6 months if you read the condition. And Dizzy Dancer is a horse who really seemed to like it here at Grants Pass last year. Trainer Quinn Howie had a big season in 2020 at Grants Pass Downs. He's off to a fast start here this year in 2021, going 2 for 5 with 2 seconds in week 1. And this is a horse with an affinity for this track. Had a pretty long campaign throughout the winter down at Turf Paradise. Ran 6 times over the course of basically 3.5 months. Had 1 second place finish for the $3,000 level. I think maybe just the water's a little bit deep down there. But this was a horse who not only had success here at Grants Pass, but had success closing, which is not always the easiest thing to do. You know, this is a race that doesn't have a lot of speed. In fact, there's really kind of no clear speed. I think the number 6, Wings of Wisdom, is going to be the pace setter. And going 6.5 furlongs here for this horse, is been close up going shorter and seems to fade when they go longer. But last time, or 2 starts back at this condition, so 4 starts back total, ran a decent race to finish 4th. And so I thought maybe if this one really woke up here, was able to get a clear lead, maybe could take him a little ways. But I think that the number 1 is certainly going to be a deserving favorite. The number 4, Attercop, just did no running in the seasonal debut last week. Started on opening night. Just kind of started far back and just never made any impression. I got to think things will be a little bit tighter here for trainer Jorge Rosales, who's 27% second time off the layoff. So the screws should be a little bit tighter for that one in the first race. Our second race, generally our quarter horse races will be races 2 and 3. Once in a while we'll have a stake later on in the program. But tonight it's a 2 and 3, and it's Oregon Bred Maidens going 350 yards, and actually a pretty decent little group of Oregon Bred Maidens here. The number 2, Miss Fancy Alia, was 3rd in our Futurity trial before finishing 4th in last fall's Futurity, and this horse has been knocking on the door and, you know, running in Futurity trials and stuff, just hadn't gotten through to break the maiden yet. So obviously that's the objective on a Tuesday's card, and I don't know, I thought a horse with a decent chance. The number 3, Ching's Pumba, 3rd in the debut after kind of getting pinched in the middle stages of the race, and so I thought maybe one worth watching with a little bit better trip this time. But I do think the number 7, Marcelino, is going to be a pretty heavy favorite here. This horse actually did break its maiden but was disqualified for interference in a 10-horse field in a career debut. Came back in a Futurity trial to get beat by just a head, then ran in the Far West Futurity, and, you know, no shame running 6th in a race like that. And so if Marcelino comes back at all what he was last year as a 2-year-old, going to be pretty tough in the spot. I would think a pretty big favorite, and probably a single along with the 1 in the first race for a lot of people who might go single, single, spread, spread in their early pick 4. The third race, as I said, I think a little bit more wide open. You get a big field of 9 here. It's a non-winner of 2 allowance race. I wanted to bring up the number 4, Holly Van Gogh, who ran on opening weekend, in fact, on opening night, and ran a pretty decent 2nd to Chumbly. It was kind of a 2-horse race for much of the journey. They broke right next to each other. Chumbly ended up prevailing in that one as Holly Van Gogh drifted out just a little bit. But I thought it was a pretty encouraging. First of all, it was first time against winners, and also it was the seasonal debut. The horse hadn't run in 10 months, so a little move forward here for Holly Van Gogh could make a big difference. A lot of people, I think, going to gear towards the number 6 for some. Jess Hector Magallanes, of course, very solid quarter horse trainer here in the Northwest over the years. This horse won the maiden at Los Al, 2 back, 4th last time out in an allowance and only beaten a half length. It was a small field of 4, but it was a pretty tight-knit pack. And, of course, those races at Los Al can be pretty salty. I thought maybe a long shot to take a peek at was the number 7, Addie's Dream, who you know, kind of just ran decently. Was fourth behind Holly Van Gogh last time out. Faded a little bit late, and I just thought maybe this one with a little seasoning under the belt might be able to run a good one here. 10-1 on the morning line if you're maybe interested in a little price horse. The jackpot pick five begins in race number four. Now, these Tuesday programs, I always tape these on Sunday, so we don't know what happened Monday night. There was 11,000 going into the Monday night card in the jackpot carryover, so be sure to stick to gpdowns.com and our social platforms, or to just Equibase, and you can make sure to follow along and know whether or not there's any money in the jackpot pool. And of course, the jackpot pool, you have to be the only winning ticket to take it down. Otherwise, half of it rolls over to the next night's card. So do be aware of that when you're playing the jackpot pick five. The number two, I'm Not Gabby, 9-5. Trainer Jason Homer only started three last week, but he had some good runs. The horse that won for him came from last to win, which, again, something we don't see all that often here. He also had a second-place finish. So his horses, at least opening week, two of the three ran pretty good. And I'm Not Gabby is one of his that last time out here at Grants Pass ran second, but, you know, was kind of second clear all the way around. Got beat by Sir Laugh-A-Lot, who came back and won. Didn't come back next start, but did come back and win on opening weekend here at Grants Pass Down. Homer also has King of Wishes, who's actually the 8-5 favorite in this race, and one who's very lightly raced. And I think part of the reason this horse is made favorite is just it's been mostly consistent. It's just kind of run, you know, a third, a fourth, and a fifth, not beaten terribly bad, had kind of a wide trip last time, and I thought it made sense as, you know, a couple of favorites here for Jason Homer. But to me, this is a little bit of a sneaky race. I don't think it's out of the question to see somebody else jump up and win this one. Oddly enough, Jason Homer used to own the one, Seadora Proud. Tiffany McDevitt now has the horse, and that horse showed a modicum of early speed last time out, and sometimes you'll see these horses the first time, they show a little speed, they don't know what's going on, and then they fade off the scene. But maybe with some time and improvement, maybe this is one that can jump up and upset the fourth race on the card. Fifth race begins the $1 late pick four. Opening weekend, the late pick four paid gangbusters both days. Some big prices and, you know, bigger fields, just more combinations. It's just a really, really exciting bet that we have here this year at Grants Pass Downs. And the number one, Racing Ray, is a horse that did run on opening day. Finished pretty good second, actually led into to the top of the stretch before Hey Sequoia, who was a heavy favorite in the first race of the season, came and got this one. Now, that was a mile and a 16th race, so led for quite a long ways. This race is 6 furlongs, which we haven't had yet this season, and honestly, I don't know that we've ever had at Grants Pass Downs. Over the offseason, there was some construction. They extended the chute at the top of the stretch to a true quarter mile, so we can now do 440-yard quarter horse races and 6 furlong races. So it's a quarter mile run to the finish line and then a half mile trip around the oval. So it's a 2-turn, 6 furlongs. I was talking with my boss, Randy, about this the other day. He really thinks these are going to be riders' races because you have such a long time now. You know, the 5 furlong races here, you have a furlong to try to establish position. You'll see it's often kind of a mad dash to that first turn. And with these races, now you have a quarter mile to make a decision and get a spot. And, you know, the first turn here at Grants Pass, it's such a pivotal part of these races. We've saw horses on opening weekend who couldn't get over to less than the 3 path, and they end up cornering very wide, and it takes them right out of the race. And so really curious to see how these 6 furlong races play with so much time for the horses and riders to kind of situate themselves. But I wanted to bring attention also to the number two, Capes Hot Rocket, who just ran abysmally last week in the Caveman, but it wasn't his fault. I mean, he came away very, very slow and was just really never involved. And I think they just kind of decided, look, let's just, you know, we'll pack it up and come back another day. Now, it's 2 straight bad finishes, but it's 2 straight bad finishes against Stakes Company, where the horse didn't get the trip it wants. This is a horse that wants to be on the lead, going to the front, and, you know, trying to say, take me as far as you can, and they weren't able to do that either the last 2 starts. So I look for some improvement for this one, if able to get up and get the lead. There are a few other ones in here that have some early speed, including the number 5, Megatron Ruler, who went wire to wire in its last start, going 6.5 here. Again, I mentioned Jackie Smith on the show the other day, off to a very fast start. Megatron Ruler's 6-for-12 career at Grants Pass Downs. Do want to give a shout to trainer James Craig, who was our trainer of the week last week with 2 wins from 4 starts. He has the number 6, Storm on the River, who's making a seasonal debut here. This horse had a pretty nice fall last year, had a win, and had 3 second-place finishes from 4 starts during the fall meet at Grants Pass Downs. So the horse coming off the layoff, Craig, over 90 days away, 14%, solid stat for a Storm on the River. So I thought kind of an interesting little fifth race, and not the easiest way, I don't think, to kick off the late pick four. I think you have a couple of different options in terms of selections in there. Race 6 is a non-winner of two lifetime event in a field of 10 here, so one of our bigger fields of the night, in fact, a full field of 10. And Vic's Hero, the number one, 7-2 on the morning line for Jory Scriver, who got off to a fast start on opening weekend. Trainer Billy Christian didn't have a very good start the first week, but he's had a very good 2021. He had a nice meet down at Turf Paradise. This is a horse who, at its best, is on the lead and showing speed and just hasn't been able to make the lead. I mean, Turf Paradise, you know, they go pretty quick down there. And I have to think that from the rail, going 5.5 here, Vic's Hero, Jory's going to be very aggressive from the inside. And if this one can make the lead going into the turn and handle the turn well, could be long gone in this spot. But Love You LC, the 5 horse, also a horse who likes to mix it up early and you know, should be pretty good. I wanted to bring up a trip horse, the number 6, Bob Again. This was a race where Bob Again got, you know, kind of didn't break all that great and then was way, way wide on the outside, just never got going. I kind of liked the horse actually as a long shot last time. Drops in class severely. Hopefully wakes up a little bit with the poor effort first time out this season. And I thought maybe a bit of a contender here in this race. The number 9, Seventh Wave, was part of a race where the horse was up close and just got completely taken out on the back stretch. It was the same race as Bob Again, but you don't see it. But there was a horse that lugged out from the inside that kind of bothered 3 or 4 horses. And so you don't see Bob Again get the comment in the program. You do see number 9, Seventh Wave, with the comment, took up the backstretch. And the horse that was disqualified was actually placed behind Seventh Wave because Bob Again wasn't directly affected. So that's why, you know, the DQ didn't affect that one. But it was a bit of a cluster there on the backstretch and worth watching the replay of, honestly, because I think you'll be very forgiving of both horses, I think, for pretty subpar efforts in that first start of the year for them. Seventh race in the feature spot, which kicks off our late daily double, also offers 50-cent superfecta wagering. It's an allowance event and drew a field of 10 here. Again, a pretty fun little late pick 4 at Grants Pass Downs this week. Emilio Guerrero brings in Year of the Ox, who was trained by Jonathan Wong down at Golden Gate Fields. This horse has won 2 straight at Golden Gate, won its non-winner of 2 life and a non-winner of 2 for a period of time. So coming into the race in good form, but has been off for a little while, and it looked like there was a voided claim there too, so there might have been a small injury, but the horse has been back working at Golden Gate Fields, came up to Grants Pass, worked 3 furlongs the other day. I think is probably going to be a somewhat decent-sized favorite in here, but it's a pretty decent group. Starboard List down toward the inside had a nice win last year here at the meet, and a few other speed types. I just thought it was, I didn't think Year of the Ox was any kind of gimme. We've seen a few short price favorites already lose here at Grants Pass Downs. Want to mention the number 8, Tune to Win, for Quinn Howie. This horse was last seen in the Grants Pass Mile, finishing 3rd. Now, Pulpit's Power didn't come back to run all that great in the stakes race last weekend, but, you know, that's not crazy to think can happen, even though the horse won our biggest race last year. But Tune to Win was a very good 3rd in the Grants Pass Mile last year. Foolish to Deceive, I thought, was a little bit of a sneaky horse in here at 6-1 on the morning line. It's the number 9 horse. And Dusty Crystal, the trainer, 25% over 90 days away. So winning 1 out of 4 times from 16 starts. And this is a horse coming off the layoff. You know, you look at some of the horses in this one's PPs, including 2 starts back, you know, finishing 5th to El Alto Hombre, who won our opening night stakes. BS Cyclotron was a really good sprinter here last year. I just think that Foolish to Deceive is running against some really good horses, and this race might be a little easier than some of those ones that show up in the program. So maybe worth a look in the 7th race. Our 8th and final race, it's fillies and mares. It's 5.5 furlongs, and it is a field of 7 set to roll that distance. And a couple of horses that ran last week, but Aspen Again, the number 3, this one is going to be kind of the question mark of the race because, you know, Golden Gate shippers in general have fared pretty well here, at least in the time I've been at Grants Pass Downs. And Jorge Rosales is very good first time with a horse, 27%. Rosales didn't have a very good first weekend, so curious to see if he can get kind of back on track or if maybe it's just a slow start for the season for him. This horse showed a lot of speed last time before fading. Again, I think because it's a Golden Gate shipper with some speed, I think this horse is going to get some attention. But I did not think it was just some automatic winner. So we'll see if Rosales can move the horse up a little bit. Giacomina ran on opening weekend, going 5 furlongs, gets a little bit more distance here, and really didn't do a ton of running in the seasonal debut, but it was just a seasonal debut. I thought the 5, Chicolina, who ran last week, ran kind of a sneaky good race, just kind of ran up the inside and followed Sizzling Grace, who rallied up the rail to get the nose win in that one. The number 6, San Juan Storm, very consistent, 5 second place finishes from 15 starts. For me, these are just the kind of horses who always take a lot of money and just don't win all that often. And obviously, if you're 0 for 15, you're not winning ever. But, you know, it's not unheard of for horses to break their maiden in their 16th or later starts. I just think that sometimes the ones that are kind of consistently second get overbet in spots like this, and they're horses that maybe just don't love to win. So one that I would probably go against in the eighth and final. So just a quick look at the Tuesday card. Wish everybody the best as we roll through week number two here at Grants Pass Downs. Don't forget, for more information, gpdowns.com is your source for all things Grants Pass Downs, and we'll see you back next week, Racing Monday and Tuesday next week. Good luck tonight, though, on this Tuesday program.